getting the appointment. It would be hard to overemphasize the importance of appointments in the sales process. Most initial sales to customers come in some sort of formal meeting, and setting that meeting, getting the appointment, gets everything started. That appointment is really the first sale you make to your prospect. You get him or her to agree to meet you to talk about the product you are selling. When customers say yes to the appointment, they are confirming that they are ready to buy. This power tip will help explain how to prepare for appointment setting, how to effectively introduce yourself, how to get potential customers to agree to an appointment, and how to follow up. Let's look at preparation. This is an Amway initial contact worksheet. If you don't have one, it's easy to make on your own. This initial contact worksheet will help you organize your calls, improve your efficiency, and most importantly, increase the number of calls that result in appointments. The first question is, what is important to remember about the person during the contact? Jot down whatever you know. Perhaps you already have a lead from your referral on the type of product he or she is likely to want. Or maybe you know about outside interests that might influence a product decision. They like to bike or hike, or they have young children. Or perhaps you want to remember something that will break the ice in your initial conversation. Basically, the more you know about the person, the better prepared you'll be. The second question is, what kind of appointment you are looking for? Do you want to meet at this person's house, at your house, or at a neutral site? Do you think this entire sales process should be handled over the phone? The third question is critical and probably calls for some rehearsing on your part. What do you plan to say to get to the purpose of the call? This will probably depend on how you've been referred to the prospect. You'll probably want to mention that person, or maybe you are following up from a casual contact you had earlier. However you were introduced to this person, you will need a comfortable, non-threatening way to break the ice. The fourth question is also important. What kind of products you identified are relevant for this person? This will be based on what your referral told you, or on earlier contact or conversation you had with this person. It's important to identify the most relevant products. You don't want to waste a person's time on products that he or she has little interest in. The next question is a natural transition. What questions do you plan to ask to get a clearer picture of the product that will interest this person? You may only have a faint idea of the products this person will want to learn more about. Asking the right questions and making the right suggestions will greatly improve your chances at making a sale. The next question is obviously critical in getting the appointment. What will you say to ask for the appointment? You'll want to consider how you'll lead into this critical question. Engaging the timing of this question will be crucial. But it's a good idea to know how you think you'll finally ask for or make the suggestion of an actual sales appointment. Chances are very good that you'll hear some objections to an appointment. I'm too busy. I haven't got time. I don't think I'm interested. You'll probably hear these kinds of things. An objection to a sales appointment is no different than an objection to a sale. You should try to anticipate objections and be ready to overcome them. Too busy? Haven't got time? I certainly understand, but I can rearrange my schedule to fit yours, and it won't take that long. How about next Tuesday at 6 p.m.? Not interested? You know, a lot of people have told me that, but when they see the products for themselves, they usually change their minds. What do you say we get together tomorrow? Initially, prospects may have objections to setting an appointment. You need to anticipate the objections and overcome them. Closing the initial contact is usually a straightforward process. You want to set the time and place for the sales appointment. And if it's more than a few days off, you'll probably want to send some sort of reminder. The initial contact worksheet will help you prepare for that critical conversation where you try to get a commitment for an appointment. Now, let's go a little deeper into actually getting that appointment by making an effective introduction. In most cases, you'll probably make the first contact over the telephone. Based on how you've been introduced to the prospect will determine your initial conversation. If you've been referred from a mutual acquaintance, you'll want to be sure to mention that person. Hello Aarti, I'm Radha, a friend of Madhubala. Madhu and I have been doing business and she suggested I give you a call. Do you have a minute to talk? Oh, for someone you have just met. Hello Aarti, I'm Radha. We met at the Chamber of Commerce meeting last week. I wonder if you have a few minutes to talk? Or for friends and relatives. Hi Aarti, I'm Radha. I'm calling to talk about the artistry renewing peel we discussed last week. Do you have a minute to talk? Obviously, you'll want to work around that person's availability. If the prospect gives signs that this is not a good time to talk, ask to set up a time that is more convenient. You want to be a consultant to that person, and you can start by honoring time limitations. Introductions don't take that long, so sometimes it's easy to gloss over them. But that's a big mistake, because your introduction sets the stage for everything that follows. Remember that old cliche? You never get a second chance to make a first impression. Give your introductions the time they deserve. Work on them, practice them, and become comfortable handling different introductions with different prospects in different situations. In making that initial contact, your purpose is to get an appointment. But in doing that, you want to determine what the customer needs or wants. That will better prepare you for an effective first sales meeting. Here are three keys to doing that. First, keep the conversation going. The prospect may want to dismiss the call quickly, so you should be ready with ways to keep the conversation going. Mutual interests or things you may have learnt about the person, you should go over those ideas in preparing your initial contact worksheet. Listen actively. This is good advice in any sales presentation. The more you listen, the more you'll be able to gauge your prospect's needs and wants, and the better you'll be able to meet them. And as you listen, be on the alert to identify new products that might be suitable for this person. If they mention they do a lot of physical activity, that could mean they would benefit from Nutrilite protein, for instance. Now, let's look at our third step in the process. Actually getting your prospect to agree to an appointment. This is the critical moment of the call. It's comparable to the close in an actual sales presentation. In this case, you're not trying to close on a sale, you are trying to close on the appointment. However, there's a lot of similarities to closing on a sale. You'll probably have to overcome some objections. And it's likely you'll need to ask for the close or the appointment more than once. You'll need to be attentive to their needs. As for timing and location, do you do it at their residence, at yours, or a neutral site, like a coffee shop? Getting an appointment is a critical step in the selling process, and you can't expect to be an expert the first time you try. That's why it's important to practice your technique. Fill out an initial contact worksheet and then practice with a friend or even a fellow Amway business owner. Go through a few phone calls until you're comfortable with your technique. Review your results with your partner and improve the performances. Now, let's look at the final step in setting an appointment. Follow-up. Of course, the follow-up to a successful appointment call is to conduct the sales call, delivering on the products the prospect has expressed interest in. However, even if your appointment call was unsuccessful, your customer did not agree to meet for a sales presentation, that doesn't mean that person will never buy products from you. Even if he or she declines the appointment, make a note of his or her interest in any products and put that person in your file for future follow-up. A no today doesn't necessarily mean a no forever. In summary, there are four keys to the appointment setting process. First is preparation. Use the Amway Initial Contact Worksheet or create your own if you don't have one. Answering those questions will prepare you for the specific prospect you will be talking to. Second, give a lot of attention to your introduction. It sets the tone for everything that follows. And don't be embarrassed to practice your introductions with family or friends. Third, you want to close the appointment the same way you would close a sale. You need to listen actively. You need to be attentive to new product needs that may come up. And most of all, you need to anticipate objections to the appointment and be ready to overcome them. And finally, follow up. On a successful appointment call, that means following up with a sales presentation. But even if you don't set up an appointment, you should put that person on file for future contact. Appointments are the first critical step in making a sale. More appointments mean more sales for you.